We want to solve the given multi-step linear equation in one variable. We do have some steps to solve multi-step linear equations below here in red. The main thing to remember though is that the goal is to isolate the variable on one side of the equation. Now this equation looks a little bit more challenging because it does contain fractions. And looking at the first step below, we want to clear the fractions or decimals from this equation. To do this, we want to multiply every term in the equation by what would be the least common denominator when we have a denominator of 5 and 4, which should also be the least common multiple of 5 and 4. So in this case, we want to multiply every term by 20, and that should eliminate the fractions from the equation. If you have a hard time determining what the least common denominator would be, you can just multiply the denominators together. It may not be the least common denominator, but it would still work. We just require additional simplifying later. So we're going to multiply every term in this equation by 20, which will produce an equivalent equation with no fractions. So we'll have 20 times 2/5 x times 2/5 x plus 20 times 4. This must equal 20 times 1/4 x. Now when fractions are involved, I'm going to go ahead and put the 20 over 1. And now we're going to go ahead and determine each of these products. Looking at this first product, notice that 5 and 20 share a common factor of 5. There's 1 5 and 5 and 4 5s and 20. Notice now our denominator is equal to 1. So when we multiply, we're just going to have 4 times 2 times x. That's going to give us 8x plus 20 times 4, that's 80, must equal 20 times 1/4. And again, this simplifies. There's a common factor of 4 here. There's 1, 4, and 4, and 5, 4s, and 20. Again, notice the denominator is equal to 1, so we just have 5x. So we've cleared the fractions now, and the solution to this equation is the same as the solution to the original equation. Remember, our goal is to isolate the variable on one side of the equation, and right now we have variable terms on both sides. So we need to add or subtract in order to have the variable on one side. So if we want to eliminate the positive 8x on the left side of the equation, we could subtract 8x on both sides of the equation. If we want to eliminate the 5x on the right, we could subtract 5x on both sides of the equation. We'll actually have a little less work if we subtract 8x on both sides of the equation. Again, the reason we're doing this is 8x minus 8x would be 0, so now this x term on the left is gone, and we're left with 80 equals 5x minus 8x, which would be negative 3x. And now we're one step away. Negative 3x means negative 3 times x, so to undo this multiplication and isolate the variable, we'll divide both sides by negative 3. Negative 3 divided by negative 3 is positive 1, and 1 times x is x. And 80 and 3 do not have any common factors, so we can express this in a couple of ways. If we want to leave it as an improper fraction or in fraction form, it would just be negative 80/3, which is probably how you would see the solution listed, but we could convert this to a mixed number. Let's go ahead and just show that. So if we have x equals negative 80/3. Remember, it doesn't matter which side the variable is on as long as it's isolated. This would also be equal to a negative mixed number. So to find the mixed number, we would take 80 and divide by 3. Well, there are 2 3's in 8. 2 times 3 is 6. 2 bring down the 0. And there are 6 3's in 20. 6 times 3 is 18. Have a remainder of 2, which means negative 80/3 is equal to negative 26. Then the fraction part is going to be the remainder over the divisor, so we have negative 26 and 2/3. Again, these are equivalent. One is written as an improper fraction, and one is written as a mixed number. I hope you found this helpful, and again, we'll take a look at more examples in the next video.